Alrighty, boys and girls. Now, as Pepe is going for its next leg up, next run, showing some strength, the Pepe season is here. And even a meme coin season is beginning right now. We can see this on every major meme coin right now, rallying. And it's now time to be looking at these low market cap gems. As I've shared with you guys, Toshi at 8 million, ladies at 20 million, even Floki back on YouTube, 300 million, Pepe on YouTube, 400 million, Bonk on YouTube, 100 million. These are all now way, way higher. And at some point, it's gonna be super tough to find a gem that is under $10 million in its market cap. As we progress in this bull market, as the market price in those meme coins, the game is gonna get tougher to find new gems. But today, luckily, we have another gem that I've been sharing with you recently, which is OG Brett on ETH. So a Brett on ETH is inevitable. It's gonna happen because we have most of the Pepeverse coins are possibly gonna play out on ETH. So in today's video, we're gonna be talking about why I do think this is the most undervalued meme coin right now at only $1 million in its market cap. So with no further ado, guys, let's get to today's video. And as usual, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. And remember, this is not financial advice. This show is for entertainment and some education and hopefully finding God. Now, guys, very important now why I do think Brett on ETH is gonna make millions this time. First of all, lowest market cap of all. Now, this far, we know that the Pepeverse is gonna play out this cycle. And we all know now the problem with meme coins. It's the long term. People buying now for the bull market. Like in the past, when I got into Toshi at 8 million and I shared it with you here, even if you were on my Discord, I shared it at around 2 million. You can go on my Discord, link in the description is free to join. You can scroll back up. And back then, the base narrative was so early that it was obvious that this is gonna ride the bull market, right? And still Toshi is gonna ride the bull market. But today, if you wanna make millions, you need to find those low market cap gems. This is very important. You don't wanna find the high market cap ones. No. Today, the Pepeverse narrative is possibly the strongest narrative out there. As we can see, Pepe coin right now is one of the strongest meme coins. And this landscape here that you see here, the top meme coins by market cap, this is not gonna change that much. Like you can even see it with Shiba Inu. Shiba Inu is still the second top meme coin by market cap. Since it got to that second spot, it's still there. Although I do think Pepe is gonna flip it, but you can see once Pepe got to that third spot, nobody took that spot. So this is gonna keep going. The E-chain is gonna support Pepe, is gonna support the Pepeverse coin. And when we are thinking long term, when we're finding a gem, a blue chip in the making, when we try to find those, we try to find some sort of a link between them and the current narratives that are playing in front of our eyes right now that could help them ride through the bull market. Because people, when they come in the future, they are not going to be looking at new meme coins. They are going to be looking at the top ones, and they're going to base their research upon those top meme coins. They're going to be looking at dog with hat, and they're going to try to find another dog with a hat or something else with a hat. They're going to see Pepe, and they're going to learn about the Pepeverse, and gonna try to find the Pepeverse. And very likely we're gonna have Book of Something as well, narrative. And once we get there, people are gonna try to find Book of Something. Although now it's pretty early, right? I'm still trying to find a Book of Something that is a legit Solana meme coin. Now there is Eskid, still kind of got that potential of the long-term play. And we got Vita Inu as well, could ride the Flokiverse, right? As Floki gonna stay here. But then for Pepe, we only got Brett on base, but Brett on base got competition with Toshi. So the Pepeverse on ETH are the ones that have no competition when it comes to the Pepeverse on ETH. And that is why OG Brett here is the most bullish low market cap coin gem, a blue chip in the making. And you can see I shared with you this earlier, it's already pumping, but this has just started. Now let's talk about it now here. What makes it a bullish coin, a bullish Brett on ETH? Now this one was launched July last year. This is the oldest Brett on ETH. That's why it's called OG Brett, right? So it was launched, nothing happened. Then a community takeover happened here. And then the rally started. It started accumulating, and then another rally. And now again, it's accumulating. Now this is around 1 million. It went up to 1.5. Now it's 1 million. So it's still accumulating. Something like this here is going to play out again here before the run. Another point is because it was launched on July, this plays a big role because this was the time where Pepe coin, Pepe, the Pepeverse coin started to launch. And a lot of people are going to put a lot of thought behind this, a lot of emphasis around this is the oldest. It's since 2023. People are going to come in the bull market, 2025, peak bull, euphoria, FOMO, they're going to see those things. Now, the second thing is their website. So if we look at their website, it's pretty close to the Pepe website. It's playing on that Pepeverse narrative. And this is what gets those people that buy. Things as simple as a website that is close to Pepe is what's going to get people in the future. Simple things. And and also their Twitter page. So by the way, if you want to check their Twitter page, you go to their website and you click Twitter. And the Twitter page is slowly grinding, slowly growing, slowly defeating the competition, because there was another Bread on Soul. It got defeated. It's dying. And they possibly got the best art out there, which is important. I'm gonna talk about why this is important as well. So they got the best art. They got their own art special to them. No other Bread, because there are some other Breads. There are some other Breads trying to claim the name, but this is the only one I think that's gonna make it in the bull market. But anyways, let's get to this, right? So they got their own art and their Twitter page is slowly growing, which is very important. And the community is working hard and they are gonna stay around for the bull market to push this as hard as possible and stay around as long as possible. Also very important to know that this is a community takeover. There are no insiders. There are nobody behind this. This is pure community. There is nobody, one person behind this. We are not an individual. We are an army. This is not one person, right? So usually you see one guy launching a coin and that's it. This is an army. This is a lot of people behind this, which means a lot of work behind the scenes, a lot of stuff happening with this coin. This is why it's the most bullish Pepeverse coin at $1 million in its market cap. Now keep that in mind. This has the highest potential. At 1 million, it goes to 100 million, is already 100x, and it could even do a billion or more. We all know what these Pepeverse coins do. This is the cheapest stuff possible. This is like me when I shared back in the days, Toshi at 8 million or at 2 million and other meme coins at way lower price. This is it, guys. This is the coin for the bull market. I'm holding this coin. This really reminds me early days Pepe. I'm gonna hold this coin for bull market. This is early days Pepe. This is early days any coin that is a strong meme coin on ETH. Today we got APU running. We got more coin running. Suddenly meme coins on ETH are running, because as I explained yesterday, we got the ETH season coming. Solana got diluted with pump.fun. Base chain now got diluted with a lot of base chain. Everyone is farming on base chain coins. So ETH now is king. ETH ETF is coming. ETH is gonna skyrocket. ETH is full of whales. ETH got everything, right? You can also check their Telegram page. So their Telegram page, you can check it from here, from the website. You can go and see for yourself. Their community as strong as possible. They're the strongest community I've seen for this market cap this far. And to show you guys an example of how early this is, right? So recently with the Pepe rally, a lot of these success stories are gonna come up, right? So this is like previous bull market, we started seeing the same things with Shiba Inu. This is basically how a meme coin season starts. A Cointelegraph, a big page, shows some P&L like that, and then everyone starts FOMOing. This is the beginning, guys. This is how it starts. An unknown trader turned 3K to 46 million with Pepe, and they even got the address, right? So this shows you, this is Dex Screener. It shows you from where this guy got in and where he got out. This him or she or whoever. So you can see the green here is the buy. So this tiny here, this is like as early as where Brett is here now. So at these prices, you can grab a lot of coins. So this is the first rally. This is when it got listed on Binance, by the way. This went, so nothing was happening. It slowly kept grinding 1 million, 2 million, 10 million, 20 million, and then like nothing. And then got listed on Binance, right? When it got listed to Binance, now granted, this guy took some profits because Binance usually listings are a top signal. But this guy being a G strong diamond handed guy did not G'd all his bags, just took some profits, right? Just some profits, and then held throughout this long time. This was 1 year, by the way, here, and probably he was watching my videos. Congrats, buddy, if you are watching. So throughout this period here, I was making videos about Pepe and I was saying this is possibly the most bullish meme coin out there. And then on the rally app, he started selling again, selling. But you can see like this guy is pretty smart, taking small profits along the way, but this adds up, right? This added up to $46 million with Pepe, and probably he's still holding. Probably this guy is gonna end up with 100 or more by the end of the bull market. But this is just to show you an example. These things happen all the time. When you get in early on some coin, you wanna hold. It took this guy over a year and a half, and this goes for Bread. This is gonna be a long-term play. This is not your pump.fun coin. Like you get in now and you get out and that's it. This is the long-term play. This is Pepeverse. This is the Bread on ETH. $1 million in its market cap. This is like the earliest possible. And to give you another example, guys, this is another Pepeverse coin in the narrative, which is the Pepe coin. So there is Pepe, which is this one, right? This guy drinking the coffee here that is listed on Binance and all that. And we got the Pepe coin. So sometimes I say Pepe, sometimes I say Pepe coin. People get confused. confused. So usually I say PepeCon, I mean this one. Because just to not be confused, I always mean this one. But now I'm talking PepeCon, now I'm meaning this one, the PepeCoin. So this one is at $400 million in its market cap. So this went to $800 million, like Breton Base. So a lot of them just make those rallies. But anyways, this is a Pepeverse coin. And what I want to show you here is, look at that now. So what you see here, guys, tell me what you notice here. So this was just ranging around $1 million in its market cap. Nothing happening, nothing. And then suddenly we see this first spike, right? Pepe started this run, they all started running. It was the season, like we're starting now. This is the ETH season. And it started here, December, and then at January when Pepe made its run, it started making this rally. And then it ran to 140 million, and then it went down. So this is very, very important because it shows the Pepeverse coins are so strong. A lot of people understand this is the narrative of the future. This is the bull market's narrative. It went back down to 17 million. Nobody picked it up. And then it ran again to 800 million. Just to show you, if you compare these charts, now this is also still a micro cap. Now keep in mind, this one was ranging around 1 million for a long time. This one is ranging for around 500K, and then now at million, and it's gonna keep ranging, probably break out soon, because now we have the Pepeverse season starting, and we're gonna see something similar, like this go range, then pump, then come back range, then pump, and then slowly, suddenly, we're gonna see one day this happening, right? This happening. That's why I do think it's early. Personally, I do think it's early. It's not financial advice, but I do think it's early. Meme coins on ETH, Pepeverse, no brainer at this point. They all repeat the same pattern. Also, to repeat that, this is all, this is July, launched on July. This one launched April 2023. So they all got launched last year. That's why they call them the OG, right? OG bread. Nothing is happening. You can see this Pepeverse meme coins on ETH are poised for the run. Because at some point, guys, the market sees these coins are active, sees their community. These names keeps repeating. People keep seeing those coins. The market at some point priced them in, right? So what started this rally? A lot of people started seeing this. A lot of people started seeing and noticing Pepe and noticing all that stuff. And then people found out of Pepe here. This Pepe got listed on Binance on May 2023. Suddenly everyone started to notice the Pepeverse. And what happened? People started searching. So now you are early on bread, by the way. You are as early that nobody's talking about this coin right now, besides me. So this is as early as it gets. So people started searching. And at some point, people are gonna start to search about other coins and gonna find out about this, and we're gonna see something similar like this. Even though it rallied here, went to 100 million, and it was right at the time when Pepe started. This also was a Pepeverse season, but it wasn't really as ingrained in people's minds as when Pepe got listed on Binance. That was it. That was like, all right, so now we understand Binance, we understand the big people, we understand what they want to do. They want the Pepeverse, and Pepeverse is gonna win this cycle. People started searching, they found about this one, and suddenly it started running. Like, that's the point here. That is very likely with Brett on ETH, as long as the community is working. Sometimes I'm on their Twitter spaces. You can tune in, you can learn more, you can join their Telegram, you can check out their Twitter page, go to their website. Everything is here. You want the Dex screener, you click on Dex screener. You want to check the Uniswap links here, Telegram here, Twitter page here. This is possibly that coin, right? So I'm doing my research. I'm trying to find, I'm sharing with you stuff that nobody's sharing this far, right? Early stuff. Now it's still risky, don't get me wrong, but this is how you find those early blue chips. You find the long-term stuff. And you notice I don't share much those quick in and out coins, because I better spend my time searching something long-term like Pepe and catch something like this, or like 3K into 40 million, than try to double my money on some pump those fun coin. That's how we do things. And that is how I find these coins early. Anyways, guys, I'll leave you the link in the description or comment section. You can check their website, as I explained you guys here. Everything is here on their website, Twitter, Telegram, Disc Screener, and everything like that. This is possibly the earliest blue chip gem out there now on ETH, in the right time to be accumulating right now. You can also join my Discord, link in the description, is free to join. And remember, for those wondering, we're still in a bull market. Bitcoin just closed a massive, massive green daily candle while everyone was bearish, while everyone was telling you we are going down, it's over. Pepe is still going for it. So we're still going higher. Remember that, guys. It's very important. If we look at this guy here, if he was shaken out here at the lows, if he saw that Pepe was going down and he thought that's it, it's over, and sold everything, he would have never made money. He would probably have made maybe 100K out of 3K. Now he's up to 46 million cashed out, and then maybe some. So that's how it plays out, guys. Don't get shaken out by this market. This is happening. The Pepeverse is happening. The Breton ETH and Pepe coin, the Pepeverse is happening. It's gonna happen, this bull market. I remember here with Pepe, I made a video and I said that's it, that's the bottom on Pepe, because people did not believe, right? People weren't spending so much time around these Dex screener and looking at every new fresh coin and studying and searching. People were not doing that. People, they just knew about Pepe just when it got listed to combine it because they did not know. But then here I said, that's it, guys. Wrap it up. We're moving up. You can check my YouTube. Everything is there. Everything is public on my YouTube. You can see PayPay. You can see every coin early. Not even meme coins. Utility coins way before when most of the people were bearish because people still think we're going in a downtrend or like some bear market or something like that. We are still going in a bull market. This is when money is made. When the top will come, you will know it. For now, we're still going higher. This is very important. You can also follow me on Twitter. Link in the description. Link in the comment section. And we're gonna wrap it up here, guys. Now, thank you so much for watching till the end. We're all gonna make it. As I said, we're still going higher. I really appreciate you watching this video till the end. And I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.